The 2021 NBA Finals are officially set, and the showdown is between the Phoenix Suns and Milwaukee Bucks. Who would have thought that just a few months ago that these would be the teams representing their conferences on the NBA's biggest stage? But who wins? Who's going to take home the 2021 NBA Championship crown? In today's video, I'll be predicting the Phoenix Suns and Milwaukee Bucks NBA Finals series. Each team's strengths and weaknesses, the players who need to step up, the key to success, every little detail. Before we start, if you're new here and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe. For more NBA content like this, I'm trying to hit 17,000 subscribers, so all support would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, with that all being said, let's take a look at the 2021 NBA Finals matchup. The Phoenix Suns have shocked the world and fought their way to an NBA Finals appearance. The storylines surrounding their appearance are crazy. Chris Paul, after 16 years, is finally in the NBA Finals and has the chance to win his first NBA title. Devin Booker and DeAndre Ayton have proven to be some of the best young guys in the league, and after missing the playoffs for so long, they've made the finals in their first run. In last year's offseason, Jay Crowder left Miami, a finalist for the Suns, and was questioned by many for that decision, but he has been instrumental to their finals run, and 1 year on, it seems like the perfect decision by Jay. Obviously, we can't ignore that the Suns got a bit lucky on the way to the finals, moving past three teams who were without one of their top two players, but I don't think that should discredit the run they've been on. They've been fantastic all playoffs long and completely deserve to be in this position today. Only 4 wins to go now, and they could be the champions of the 2021 NBA season. Giannis Antetokounmpo and the Milwaukee Bucks have quietened the doubters and are officially in an NBA Finals. They blitzed the Miami Heat, a team that dismantled them last year, and followed that up by clutching up against the Brooklyn Nets in one of the most entertaining series this postseason. After losing Giannis to an injury in Game 4, the Bucks did not back down and beat the Atlanta Hawks to secure a place on the NBA's grandest stage. Like the Suns, there are a lot of storylines surrounding Milwaukee on this playoff run. Giannis has shut his doubters up and made an NBA Finals, getting over a hump he struggled to get past for years now. Chris Middleton has proven to be an incredibly valuable player to this team and had some of the best shooting games of the playoffs, and guys like Drew Holiday, Brooke Lopez, and more all stepped up when their name was called to lift this team into the finals. Now, they're a chance to take home the championship back to Milwaukee for the first time since 1970. Anyway, with that being said now, let's take a look at the strengths and weaknesses of each team and how it will impact either side in this series, starting with the Phoenix Suns. The biggest strength of the Phoenix Suns has to be their offense overall. The team is so versatile on that end. They've got great shooters and elite mid-range artists like D-Book and Chris Paul, an interior presence in DeAndre Ayton, and those layers make them really hard to defend consistently. They just have so many ways to pick an opponent apart, and they did that last round against the Clippers pretty well. Yes, Booker got absolutely clamped by Patrick Beverley for a game or two, but overall, they were able to get the kind of shots that they wanted, so I expect them to do it again in the finals. Though it will be notably harder against the Bucks, whose defense, when healthy, is simply elite. Again, this strength is going to be particularly important this round because the Bucks are so great defensively. They have weapons like Giannis, who can defend the paint amazingly, but also switch onto the perimeter and clamp up there, as well as great perimeter defending guards like Drew Holiday. So to excel against those guys, the Suns' offense needs to be up to scratch. A big weakness for the Suns, however, is their rebounding. They rank dead last in offensive rebounds during the regular season and were one of the worst rebounding teams in the playoffs out of the 16 teams, though I will admit they have improved from the regular season. However, it's going to need to improve a whole lot more because the Milwaukee Bucks are currently the best rebounding team in the league far and wide. They are currently the only team to average over 50 boards per game in the playoffs up until this point. And the team that's in second, the New York Knicks, averaged 46 per game. That's a huge disparity and makes me anxious for this series for the Suns if this part of their game does not step up. Again, though the Suns have been better rebounding as of late, it's still not an area that they excel in. So in order to beat the Bucks, this part of their game is going to need to lift a lot because the weakness could get exposed in these finals if they're not careful. That's how good the Bucks are in this particular aspect. As for the Bucks, their biggest strength is their defense overall, particularly on the interior. But I will note that it did struggle at times against Trae Young's offense. The team was exposed in the drop coverage, and that's where Trae Young dominated. So against a player as great as Trae against drop coverage in Chris Paul, this strength will need to be as good as ever for the Bucks to win this series. With that said though, the Bucks definitely weren't bad against Atlanta and Trae defensively. They were generally great and were able to shut down isolation plays really well and locked up the paint impressively. There wasn't a whole lot of cutting to the lane and getting layup type plays by Atlanta. It was just the pick and roll where Milwaukee struggled for the first time these playoffs, so I'd still say this is a big strength of the Bucks. The Bucks also continue to dominate the glass and are easily the best rebounding side in the playoffs. So when coming up against a middle ground rebounding team in the Phoenix Suns, the Bucks will need to take a firm grip of this advantage and ensure they dominate the Suns with it, as it could be a turning point for them in the series. So again, rebounding and defense will be the two big strengths for the Bucks to key in on this series. However, the biggest weakness of the Bucks is their ability to defend the three-point line. They give up the most three-point attempts in the NBA per game, and teams shoot extremely well on them from downtown. It has slightly improved in the playoffs, but they're still giving up 35 plus 3-point attempts per game, and their opposition is taking advantage of that. Against Phoenix, a team with many knockdown shooters like Booker and Bridges, this could hurt them again if they fail to adjust. So those are the strengths and weaknesses of each team. With that said now, let's take a look at a player from each team that needs to step up and improve this series in order to give their side the best chance at winning. For the Milwaukee Bucks, Chris Middleton needs to lift because of Giannis' injury. As of when writing, it's unclear when Giannis will return and how good he'll be initially when coming back. So I believe it could be likely that he's somewhat rushed back and therefore potentially not 100%, not the same dominating player he normally is. In order to fill that void, Middleton must be great. These playoffs, it seems like Middleton plays like either Kobe or Kuzma, no in between, so he's got to be more consistent if the Bucks want to win this series. When Middleton is on fire and at his best, Milwaukee's offense is easily top 5 in the league. He's truly a special player when he gets it going. Just look at Game 3 when he scored 20 points in the last quarter. The problem is it doesn't happen all the time, and with questions around Giannis' health, it's going to need to be consistent if the Bucks want to win. A Brook Lopez 30 piece is not going to happen again, a Drew Holiday offensive showcase is not guaranteed, so when Giannis isn't there or is struggling, the offensive focus will inevitably shift to Middleton, and he needs to be ready to meet the stakes for the Bucks to win the championship. I have complete faith in Middleton to do so, as I've said, he's showcased his capability to play at an elite level before. He's just going to need to do it consistently in the NBA Finals to give the Bucks the best chance to win. Again, especially considering the circumstances currently surrounding Giannis Antetokounmpo. For the Phoenix Suns, Mikal Bridges and Jay Crowder need to step up, because they are likely going to be tasked with guarding Chris Middleton and Giannis Antetokounmpo this series. As I've just stated, for the Bucks to win this series, particularly if Giannis isn't 100% healthy, Chris Middleton needs to lift. Giannis is going to give you that 30 and 13 constantly, but you can't really ask much more of him. You can't expect him to take over and drop 50 points like a LeBron can at the flick of a switch. So he needs help from his supporting cast to get over the line. I'm not saying that's a bad thing for Giannis, that's just how he is. So being able to lock down his supporting pieces is crucial to minimizing the Bucks' offense and giving your team the best chance to win. Bridges is one of the players on the Suns who's going to enable that to happen. He has the tools to lock down a player of Middleton's caliber, and he's becoming one of the best wing defenders in the league. So if he's able to lift and slow him down to a certain degree, it places a lot more pressure on Giannis to perform and removes his other playmaking options, which can cause the Bucks to struggle. As for Crowder, last year in the bubble, he was a critical element in stopping Giannis in the Heat's 5-game upset of the Bucks. He is going to again be an important factor in limiting the 2-time MVP's impact on the series. The Suns don't really have anyone who matches up greatly with Giannis. It's going to be a team effort, so Jay's impact and defensive IQ will be a must. If these two guys can put on a show defensively, the offense down the other end will flow naturally, and as a result, allow for the Suns to run rampant over the Bucks. It's a task obviously easier said than done, especially with the Bucks adding players like Jrue Holiday to the mix. But if Bridges and Crowder can perform at a high level defensively for 4 games, there is no doubt in my mind the Suns win the series because of that. Finally, before we get into my final prediction, what are the keys to success for each team? For the Suns, them winning this series comes down to their ability to defend. Their offense is a given. I highly doubt they'll struggle on that end of the ball very often. But what will give them an edge in this series will be their ability to slow down the Bucks' offense. Phoenix was a top 10 team this past season in defensive rating, so we know how good they can be on that end. And as I've already said in this video, if the Bucks are forced into over-reliance of one player, it can be their downfall. It's why they added more playmaking to their roster last offseason. It's a tall task, I get that, but if the Suns can play some quality defense, it's going to enable them to outlast the Bucks long term. As for Milwaukee, their key to success will be having a versatile offense. Again, Giannis is injured. It's unclear what he'll play like once returning. So in the case that he maybe isn't 100% and needs some extra help offensively, his supporting cast will need to lift around him to give the Bucks the best chance of winning. If the Bucks have multiple guys firing, it opens up the floor a whole lot more and makes them a lot more difficult to defend, benefiting Giannis. Unfortunately for the Suns, they don't really have a guy on paper that can one-on-one slow down Giannis. It's going to be a team effort. But if guys like Middleton, Holiday, Lopez, Portis off the bench, etc. are playing great basketball, it's going to be extremely hard to let those guys go so the Suns can double team Giannis or force Giannis into a particular part of the court. If the Bucks can do that for 4 games, it's probable to say that they win this series. But with that all being said, after looking at the strengths and weaknesses for each team, the players who need to step up, and the keys to success, who wins the championship in 2021? The Bucks or the Suns? I'm going with the Milwaukee Bucks in 7 games, and here is why. Before you Phoenix Suns fans go off your head at me in the comments, I want to make it clear that this matchup is a huge toss-up for me. I can really see this going either way. However, I'm deciding on the Milwaukee Bucks to win the chip because of Giannis Antetokounmpo. If Giannis is at least 90% what he was before the hyperextension, the Bucks win this series. I say this because I just can't see anyone on the Suns effectively slowing him down. That's their biggest question mark. I think a guy like Jay Crowder can do a decent job, and DeAndre Ayton was fantastically defensively last series for the Suns. But even then, I think Giannis is a type of player they haven't met before, and I don't know if they can effectively shut him down. Even if they do, the Bucks are far more capable of being able to win when Giannis struggles nowadays, thanks to the addition of Jrue Holiday. The extra playmaking and offensive threat that Jrue brings to the table opens the floor up a whole lot more for Giannis these playoffs, more than ever before, and it's made the Bucks the best team in the East and a lot more versatile than previous seasons. So I think this will be hugely important for them against the Suns. With that said though, I don't believe the Bucks will kill the Suns just because of their star tandem. Because as I've mentioned, Ayton, Crowder and Bridges are all extremely capable of clamping up on a star together, whether that be Giannis, Chris or Holiday. Phoenix is hard to match up on two, which is why I have it going to seven. It's not a one-way street here. I'm not quite sure how well Drew Holiday will be able to play on Devin Booker. I think he can clamp him up for 1-2 games max, but Devin Booker has been so good these playoffs, I feel like I'd favor him more in a one-on-one matchup. My biggest question for the Bucks though, is how well can they defend the pick and roll? Because they were killed in it last series by Trae Young, and now they're playing against a team that destroyed and exposed the Nuggets in that exact facet, led by one of the masters of the pick and roll, Chris Paul. We know drop coverage won't work. Brook Lopez struggled heavily defending the PNR against Trae Young. So how will that affect the Bucks' defense and rotations? Is Coach Bud capable of making adjustments to limit the Suns' creation through those sets? We're going to have to wait and see what happens there, but it makes this series very interesting. All those question marks for both teams make this matchup, at least on paper, so intriguing and exciting to me. I genuinely cannot pick a winner. I've been tossing it up for hours now as I've wrote this script. The Bucks or the Suns, the Bucks or the Suns. But in the end, I just feel slightly more confident in the Bucks. Hence why I have them winning in 7. If Giannis is healthy for game 1, as implied by his reported timetable for return, the Suns will be facing a fully healthy team with multiple stars for the first time. I'm not saying that will cost them the series, but it definitely makes me a little bit less confident in them as they haven't come up against a healthy team of the caliber of the Bucks before. In the end, this is mainly gut feeling. It really can go either way, but something tells me this is the year of the Bucks. So I have Milwaukee winning the NBA championship in 2021. And that will conclude the video. What do you guys think of this? Who wins this championship to you? The Bucks or the Suns? And in how many games? Let me know all your predictions down in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to drop it a like and subscribe. But with that being said, I am out. Peace.